Today in this video, I will talk about nuts and seeds nutrition and why I have added them to my pre-workout breakfast. If you are interested how I prepared this healthy breakfast, check the link in the description below.
Now, before going deeper into the nuts and seeds nutritional facts, I would like to talk about why I started to be interested in nutrition and finally why nuts become a part of my pre-workout breakfast.
Since already 3 years, I am training intensively Kung Fu, and during my first year, during the winter time, I was the only person who was a vegetarian in the school, and I didn't have a good nutrition, and I didn't even worry about nutrition at that moment because I never had a problem with my body because of nutrition. But being here, being restricted with the food because I only eat what I received from the school, I got very weak and exhausted, and I actually got sick in my first year. So that made me research about nutrition, and I found out that after doing a test I had low magnesium.
It is not a surprise because with training, magnesium is so important for muscle contraction and energy production.
So I tried to find supplements, but as natural as possible. And what I found, nuts are a great source of many vitamins and minerals, also a great source of protein and fiber. That was good news for me, and I started to eat them. I also found out about chlorella and spirulina. So I created this perfect pre-workout breakfast to stay healthy, to be strong and overcome this exhaustion, and it actually really helped me.
In order to take advantage of all the nutrients present in nuts, it is good to leave them soaked in water overnight. In that way, enzymes, inhibitors and phytic acid occurring in the nuts are neutralized. Consequently, vitamins and minerals are better absorbed in the digestive tract. Also, do not eat too many of nuts as they are fat and calorie dense. Just a few of each kind is enough for breakfast. In my breakfast, I added the following nuts and seeds. Pumpkin seeds. The most nutrient pumpkin seeds are raw, taken directly from the pumpkin and prepared by yourself. They are rich in protein and antioxidants, a crucial nutrient for athletes. Protein helps in muscle recovery, antioxidants reduce an oxidative stress and inflammation after an intensive workout. Apart from that, pumpkin seeds are a very good source of manganese, magnesium, phosphorus, copper and iron, and they have been long valued as a special source of the mineral zinc. Also, traditional Chinese medicine uses pumpkin seeds to promote healthy digestion, prevent parasitic infections, and reduce stomach pain. Brazil nut, number one food source for selenium. And selenium benefits are enormous. Firstly, selenium is crucial for thyroid health. Thyroid plays a huge role in our body, influencing the function of many important organs, including the heart, brain, liver, kidney, and skin. Apart from that, selenium has been scientifically proven to lift mood and prevent depression. Brazil nuts are also tremendous anti-inflammatory foods, not only because of selenium, but also because of ellagic acid they contain. Apart from selenium, Brazil nuts are also rich in protein, fiber, magnesium, copper, thiamine, and other minerals. The next nut that I choose is almond, one of my favorite. Almonds has been found to be good for our digestive system. They contain probiotic components that help to generate good bacterial flora in the guts. And they are the only nuts that help to alkaline the digestive tract, reducing the acid buildup, helping the nutrients to be better absorbed, which is highly needed when you are training intensively. And that's not all. Almonds are a great source of vitamin E, biotin and antioxidants that nourish the skin and reduce the signs of aging. Almonds are also a good source of manganese, magnesium, riboflavin and copper. Cashew, a low-calorie nut, excellent source of copper. Copper has many great functions in our organism. It helps in energy production and antioxidant defenses, which is greatly appreciated by athletes. Also, copper is important in skin health. It takes part in the production of melanin, a skin and hair pigment, as well as formation of collagen and soft tissues, which support the skin's elasticity. Cashews are also a good source of magnesium and vitamin K. Together with copper, these minerals support bone health. Also, same as almonds, cashews improve digestion and nutrient absorption, and they are a good source of phosphorus, manganese, and zinc. They also contain iron. Walnuts, one of the healthiest nuts around. They contain one of the highest amounts of omega-3 fats of any nut. Omega-3 fats support heart health, improve mood, preserve memory, control blood sugar, and more. Also, walnuts are a very good source of manganese, copper, and a good source of biotin. They also contain magnesium and potassium. One serving of hazelnuts can provide almost an entire day's amount of manganese. Manganese is an important trace mineral needed for many vital functions, including nutrient absorption, production of digestive enzymes, bone development, and immune system defenses. Hazelnuts also have the highest content of PAC, an important antioxidant. Hazelnuts are a good source of vitamin E and copper, which promote skin health. They also contain thiamine, magnesium, and other minerals. Sunflower seeds are an excellent source of vitamin E and a very good source of copper, two nutrients that improve skin health. Sunflower seeds are also a good source of B vitamins such as thiamine, vitamin B6, folate, niacin, riboflavin, and pantothenic acid. B vitamins are very important for athletic performance, especially thiamine, riboflavin, and vitamin B6. These B vitamins are used to convert the food which we are eating into energy that the body can use during exercise. Also, folate, vitamin B9, is important for athletes because they help to repair the damaged muscle cells.
On my way of doing this healthy breakfast video,
I got a message on Instagram, and the person who wrote it claimed that nuts can be actually unhealthy because they contain a lot of fat, and raw nuts have mold particles which are very toxic for our body. So that caught my interest because most of the information available online or even from health professionals is that nuts are very, very healthy. Generally, the debate that is held online is about whether nuts are healthy for people who have cardiovascular issues. There is a diet based on Dr. Esselstyn's. It's a low-fat, whole-food, plant-based diet. It's already proved that this diet is very helpful in preventing and reversing heart diseases.
Dr. Esselstyn showed that the diet is enough. He showed very powerfully with angiograms that damaged arteries can be reversed just by following this diet.
The doctor claims that also foods such as nuts, avocados, oils should be avoided by this kind of patients. Most of the researches that shows that nuts are healthy for the heart is based on the patients that are already very sick and their diet is not really good. It's full of processed food and fast food. So adding the nuts to this kind of diet is very helpful and actually affects positively the heart.
20% of the calories from one diet, the walnut group, were derived from walnuts, offset by lesser amounts of fatty foods, meat, and visible fats, oils, margarine, and butter. So the people in the walnut group ate less meat and dairy than the control group.
However, there is still more research needed whether people who are on a healthy diet, plant-based diet, should eat nuts or not. What I found and what Vexors was talking about is that there was one Japanese guy who experimented on himself whether nuts are healthy or not, and he was long-term already plant-based diet person, and he checked his arterial elasticity before doing the experiment, so when he was on a low-fat, whole-food, plant-based diet, and after eating nuts, and it came out that his arterial elasticity worsened after eating nuts. So this is the only one experiment made by one person which kind of claims that nuts could be unhealthy for our arteries, for our heart, for our cardiovascular health. However, it's just one person and everybody have different tolerance to the food, and it really doesn't mean a lot. The fact is that, of course, if you have already advanced cardiovascular heart disease, I would probably stick with a low-fat, plant-based, whole food diet and not eat nuts, just because it's already proven. If you don't have any problems with your heart or cardiovascular disease, you are a healthy person just like me, it's nothing wrong in eating nuts. Also, my diet is not strict and I eat still sometimes some animal animal-based food. Sometimes I eat sweets and processed food. So eating nuts is healthier than the other thing. Also, I think nuts makes you full and they can help you in controlling your cravings.
Regarding the mold particles, I haven't found really information about that. I even didn't really research in this topic. So if you have some information, please write in the comments. I would really love to read about it. But to be honest, I really look at it very realistically. The food we have right now has a lot of chemicals because of the pollution and other things that are added to the food, whether it's even carrot or apple or banana or anything. So getting so detailed to each food and to actually healthy food, saying it's unhealthy, it's a bit for me too much, and we should as well not restrict ourselves so much, otherwise we get crazy and our mind and soul as well suffer for it. And for me the most important is actually our attitude and enjoying the food.
Guys, I'm very interested to hear your thoughts on that topic, so don't forget to give a comment. Also remember to watch my other videos. Stay healthy and see you in the next video.